I'd like to begin our budget workshop. Mr. Fussell, I'm going to ask you if you would kindly recap for the board and the audience where we are since our last meeting.
Sure. Your first meeting on March 5th, you agreed by consensus to reduce the budget, the growth budget, by $7.2 million. Last week's meeting, March 15th, you agreed by consensus to reduce by $0.7 million for a total of nearly $8 million of the $15 million budget gap that you started with. There's recommendations tonight that will equal $3.2 million if all of them are accepted by you. You'll still have a $2.5 million budget gap to get under the legislative cap. There has been some discussions by Albany regarding the additional monies that might be put in by the Senate and the Assembly. That has not been determined yet, so I have no additional information. Regarding the proposed $1.4 million that was reported in one of the local newspapers, so I don't know if there's any validity to that number, only time will tell. So at this point, Madam President, you have additional items that we just went through, and that should cover the explanations to what's being proposed tonight. Again, this is a very tough time that you're dealing with, and I don't envy any of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Fussell. I just have a few brief things for clarification to bring up. One, I want everyone to know that the Board of Education does, I've said this before, we do receive your emails. We do receive the letters that get turned in downtown for us. We do read these. We do review them. We do take them under consideration. When we have our discussions up here, I want you to know that if after we have read and received your options and suggestions, and I encourage you to continue. We appreciate you have taken different things out of different recommendations to help us in this very excruciating process. One of the things that does keep coming up time and time again in these suggestions is around neighborhood schools. And I feel the need to explain to everyone here the reason that, several reasons why that's not possible. The first and most important reason is because Newburgh, the North City School District, is under a court order to integrate their schools. So by going back to neighborhood schools, we would in fact be violating the law. Also, in looking at the different demographics of our district at this point, because they have changed over the years, we did examine if neighborhood schools were ever able to be put back in place, who would go where, so to speak. And with the locations of the enrollment of the students in our district, because we have grown significantly since this court order was put in place, the capacity of the actual buildings, they would not be able to hold the number of students who would be in their particular neighborhood school. So that's another issue around neighborhood school. And lastly, there's a lot of, there's a perception that there would be a huge cost savings around this, when in fact, upon detailed examination, all of our students that are currently being bused would continue to be bused. Our two towns, all of the students have to be bused. The city schools, anyone living, the elementary kids, anyone living beyond 0.6 miles have to be bused, and for the older students, it's a mile. It's a mile for the older students. So all of these students still have to be bused. So if we still have to have the routes to get the students to school, it's not going to be a savings in transportation because we still have to have all these routes to get the same amount of children going to school. So it is a perception that it would save a lot of money, when in fact it wouldn't, and the fact that we would be violating the law makes it impossible for us to do so. So I just wanted to share that information, and I encourage you to do, review the information that you send us. We appreciate your time and effort that you put in, and we appreciate any help that we can get through this process. Our first item for discussion this evening is the NFA curriculum. It's been determined to include items that we already took consensus on now, or that we leveled due to the remaining large budget cap that they now need to be revisited to conform to the tax levy limit. The curriculum was one of these items. We have the same spreadsheet related to that in our packet. The elimination of the crew team would be a reduction of $46,593. Questions and comments, please, on this item. Yes, Ms. Provost. Team. There's the Newburgh Rowing Club, which is a separate organization, and the school has a crew team. And as Ms. Prokash mentioned, it is not a New York State sanctioned school. Yes, yes, the Newburgh Rowing Club will continue to operate. We just won't have a team representing Newburgh Free Academy.
Yes, they can also continue to use all the equipment that has been.
We have to review that with our insurance advisor of our liability. Because the clubs just have affiliation with the school district.
There's a recommendation here to put two park positions back in place at an increase to the budget of $223,622. It is recommended to add back two park positions at the middle schools. When we first accepted the reductions, it was with the intent to move from a 9-period day to an 8-period day. Also, South and Heritage were going to experience a reduction in enrollment of grade 6. But since GAMS is now not accepting 6th grade next year, enrollment will not decrease, and coupled with not switching this year to an 8-period day, these positions will be necessary to service the students. You have an attached spreadsheet 7, and although the only highlighted positions are being recommended. They were previously reduction at South Middle School and Heritage. Questions or comments on this item? Consensus on adding back two positions to art at the two middle schools, Heritage and South. An increase to the budget of $223,622. Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Mr. Woodall?
Yes.
Mr. Gresh?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Ms. Prokosh?
Yes.
Our next item on the agenda is a reduction of social workers by 4 positions for a reduction to the budget of $395,376. This is once again being brought up for discussion for the board's request. The previous recommendation was for a reduction of 7. This revised recommendation is to reduce by 4. Need 5 social workers to be utilized district-wide along with the resources that will be provided by the Department of Social Services and district staff for counseling, such as the psychologists and the guidance counselors. You should be aware that there's a proposal to add 1 back due to the recommendation to bring back special needs students to the district from BOCES, and this will be discussed later in our discussion this evening. That needs to be reviewed as a separate item. So this recommendation is to eliminate 4 social workers positions for a reduction of $395,376. Questions and comments, please. Yes, Mr. Lewis.
As you know, I have always been a kind of social worker. But I understand that it helps me that we need to cut some of it. And I'm going to agree with this. And we need to cut some of it. And we need to bubble is never going to set us in position.
Yes. increase of 28.5 positions for an add back to the budget. To a reduction in the budget of $237,979. Yes? Yes. Go ahead, Mr. Excel.
Mr. Forget was reviewing IEPs with regards to the placement of about 32 students and realized that we have rooms now in two of our buildings. We're going to bring back 32 students from the placement at OSEA, saving tuition, and review the kindergarten IEPs that are going forward, or I'm sorry, pre-K IEPs going forward will become our kindergarten, and not send a bunch of them, and now we'll be running our program in-house. That's why there's an add-back of positions, 28 and a half, and you can go through the add-back of the request is to add back 6 special ed teachers, 16 teaching assistants, a psychologist, social worker, 1.5 speech and language teachers, and 1.5 occupational therapists, a half physical therapist, and 1 CSE chairperson, for 28 and a half positions. The amount of tuition that we'll be saving from OSEA is $2,117,550. The cost for those personnel is $2,005,000. Coupled with the transportation savings by not sending buses out to BOCES and different sites, the additional $126,251 in savings, the district could save $237,979 by bringing students back. Keep employed some of the already displaced employees and probably offer a program that would be better suited for the children.
$237,979. Mr. Bessel?
Yes.
Mr. Whitlow? Yes. Our next item is a reduction of the elementary teaching assistance by 21. That previously was, recommendation was at 41. So this week's recommendation is at 21. This would eliminate the grade one assistance only. The remaining, no? This item was addressed prior to meeting, decided to eliminate the grade one assistance only, I'm sorry. The remaining assistance for kindergarten were bubbled, and therefore, and that is the 41, and therefore, we're bringing it up for discussion again this evening due to the excessive budget gap that we still have. The new recommendation is to reduce an additional 21 positions, with the remaining positions to be utilized on a split basis with all the kindergarten classes. The elimination of 21 of the teaching assistants would be a reduction to the budget of $1,097,302. Comments, please. Yes, Mr. Lewis.
Again, I'm totally against cutting any assistance, especially for our kindergarten.
Included an additional 16, so in fact, when all is said and done, there's only a net of five here. They just won't be in the kindergarten class where we know that we need them. You know, it's obvious, it's not something that we want to do, it's something that we have to do. And but there will be an additional 16 coming back. Yes, go ahead.
It also lets you clarify the statement you said, Mr. Lewis. When you said money comes back, I mentioned earlier regarding the money that is in the upper grads in Albany, that meant money at $200 million at the $1.4 million. Since I don't know what's going to happen, your charge is to get down to the cap, if that's what you decide. And if that comes back at a later date, that's the money that I believe you're talking about.
Yes, Ms. Rush.
I think this is really affecting most of us, because a few of us were sitting here who pushed to get these assistants in these positions. So I just want to echo what Pop said. It's really going to be hard to have them done.
It's been very difficult because we fought so hard to get them in kindergarten and first grade. So to be sitting here and being forced to make this decision is extremely, extremely difficult. And you should know that we will do everything in our power to get them back. Other questions or comments? Yes, Ms. Prokash.
But I still believe in the indoor. So
board as we appear that it will be, we will be in this temporary situation, and I certainly hope that it's temporary. But we have to look at certainly contractual language, but I've asked that we explore field work, our college students coming in possibly to help out for the, you know, the potential year that they would be without those people in the classroom. So if they have to be gone, I'd like to get as much help as we can, but we'll have to look at contracts, and that would be something that would be done on an internship basis. So if nobody would be paid, but we're trying to get educate people in education, helping other people in education. So we will look at that certainly as a temporary fix. Other questions or comments? We'll take consensus on the reduction of elementary teaching assistants by 21 for a cost savings of $1,097,302. Yes, Mr. Lewis? Yes. I was told that I need to be in the mix here. So yes. Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levenstein?
No.
Ms. Prokosh?
No.
Mr. Vesley? Mr. Woodhull? Ms. Resch? Next item on the agenda is the position of violence prevention coordinator. It is one position at a reduction of $102,030 to the budget. This position has been vacant for the current school year, and it is the recommendation not to fill it for economic reasons only. This too was bubbled at the last meeting.
However,
I truly believe that if we start in fifth grade, we are saving some money. And I haven't had time to explore, I don't think any of us really have had time. There's some very good things that came in email today, there's some suggestions about savings and about generating some money for this program. I truly believe that music helps more than just playing an instrument. As I said before,
budget here of $31,421. There's a spreadsheet enclosed that shows us the sports and coaching positions. Many of the varsity assistant positions have been separated as per the board's request and are being recommended for reduction. You should note that not all of the varsity team assistants are being recommended to be reduced based on the size of the teams, but they are still listed here. Also being recommended are modified football teams as a reduction. As we're aware, the local municipalities currently run youth football programs that can be utilized. There are no cheerleading teams for modified football. Also, there is an email attached from the athletic director outlining the freshman level teams in other local school districts.
Is
being proposed for the $31,000. And I will take consensus on the reductions as presented for $31,421 to athletics. And we will get further information about the additional recommendations in athletics that we believe to be beyond the $50,000. So for our purposes tonight, this is for the recommended reductions in athletics to over $31,421. Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinsky?
Yes.
Mrs. Probash?
Yes.
Mr. Vesely?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull? Ms. Resch?
Yes.
Yes. $83,185. reduction of one teacher on special assignment for reduction in the budget of $83,185. Mr. Lawson? Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Mr. Bessel?
Yes.
Mr. Woodhull? Ms. Rush?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Yes. Next item is district-wide supply lines. It's recommended that most of the supply lines for the 2012-2013 be reduced by 20%. These are some lines to do health, safety, and state aid purposes that cannot, there are some lines that due to health, safety, and state aid purposes that cannot be reduced. This would be a 20% reduction in the district-wide supplies line. It would be a reduction to the budget of $208,418. Questions or comments? Ms. Prokash?
Yes.
Mr. Bessel? Mr. Woodhull?
Yes.
Mr. Lewis?
Yes.
Mrs. McAfee?
Yes.
Mr. Levinstein?
Yes.
Those are all the recommendations for reductions we have this evening, but we do have some additional information that we'll provide tonight. Schedule J. The revised Schedule J listing is for stipended positions only. We currently have a list of the Schedule J clubs, Schedule 19 in our packet. Budget to budget comparisons. This is a 4-year comparison, which includes the current year only through February of 2012. Workers' comp, unemployment, and tax certiorates. Explained at prior meetings, the operating budgets have been reduced severely, and those expenses have exceeded the budget for the past 3 years. This was done intentionally by prior boards by using planned fund balance. Fund balance analysis is included in our packet at Schedule C. We are currently planning on using another $2 million out of the fund balance to help in our having to reduce positions for the district.
Received this list, this type of position for your request. Obviously, we won't expect any recommendations tonight, but if you can formulate your recommendations and email it to me, compile and put together kind of like a list for you to discuss on what the bulk would be, what the eight of you actually decide almost by default, which ones that you want to see brought up for discussion. I mean, they're all listed here. See that the total is $209,000, that's without benefits. But if you just email me the ones that you feel strongly that maybe we should really look at and try to do without next year, or email me, and then I'll put that list together for the next budget meeting.
Also some other items, one that been brought up by Ms. Prokash, did get forwarded again to the attorneys we forwarded before, and it's around advertising and what our legal abilities to raise revenue through advertising in a school district in New York State is. So council does have that. It is being reviewed, and we are definitely looking at that again to bring revenue into the district so that we do not have to cut these types of things.
At the last meeting, this broadcast brought up regarding the amount of money. I was forwarded that article, and it was Pennsylvania School District. New York laws are completely different.
But I did look up on New York State. I didn't what engineer is saying. And what I'm reading is, I'm misreading it, is that it is allowed. It might not be the exact same formula, but it is allowed. What was done in this meeting, I'll be done here. It's not the, the billboard, but that actually is allowed.
Mr. Prokash, we've asked the attorneys to give us a written, document that states what can be and what can't be done by school districts in New York State. So hopefully by Tuesday night or regular meeting, we will have that given. Okay, because we're getting conflicting stuff.
Right.
Some stuff says New York can do this, they can do that, they can't do this. So we want to get this settled once and for all. If we have an avenue out there to earn some money for our district that can save the issues, we certainly want to do that. So we're going to make every effort.
Yes, I forwarded to Mr. Velez, our director of Building and Grounds, and Mrs. Zolman, our purchasing agent. Also, Mr. Jensen, our technology executive director, so that they can start looking into some of the materials that we have when it comes up for deeming them obsolete and resolutions passed by the board will certainly be doing that.
Because if that does come to fruition, I think we generate some money, especially cell phones.
Certainly.
I mean, my God, there's so many cell phones, people call us that.
Right. I think what I'd like to also do is certainly throughout the building principals, because if there are cell phones, well, we all know there's cell phones that are that keep getting renewed when the plan comes up. The district returns them back to the company that's going to renew them, and then that company either sends them overseas to the troops or take them to shelters. But for those phones that are in personal use at home, I'd like to circulate it through the principal's office and bring this company in so we can do this. Maybe it's a way of generating student-funded money for activities versus offsetting general taxes, because then we get into the solicitation or actually the request for fundraisers. This kind of falls into that more actually for personal items, and then we're dealing with New York again with regard to fundraising laws. So if I can just turn it over to the GO clubs or the actual schools and have the students actually run that campaign, I think it'd be better for them, and then the money goes directly to the students. Your budget gap to conform to the legislative cap stands right now at $3,161,318 that you can still exceed that 2.63 mandated cap.
Okay.
Thank you, Madam President. I just want to say a couple words in closing tonight. We appreciate your attendance here and your support. You know, sometimes people forget that the people on the stage for the most part are volunteers. You're actually board members. And they put in many, many, many hours every month. In the last 2 months, they've been really spending even more time, much more than you normally do. So I want to thank you for being here tonight. Your support means a lot to all of us on the stage. Also, it does my heart good to see so many students out there who are understanding now a little bit better how the democratic process works in the United States. So when it comes time to be American citizens, you too may be sitting on the stage making difficult decisions for your children and your grandchildren. Thank you very much.
March 29th. It will be held at 6 p.m. It will be held at Temple Hill Academy. Okay, so please, everyone make note. We'll get it up on the website as well. The reason for that is NFA's musical production begins on the 30th, the very next day, and they have a dress rehearsal where they perform for the senior citizens in the community. So there's no way that we could be here that evening. Temple Hill Academy has full 730 people, so we wanted to make sure that we would be holding it in a location where there would be plenty of room for everyone that wanted to come and listen. Also, that evening, we'll be beginning that evening, as opposed to how we usually begin here, we're beginning that evening with a guest speaker. Many of you may remember earlier in the year, we tried to bring David Little, who is New York State School Boards Association Director of Government Relations, come to speak to us about the current fiscal crisis affecting districts across New York State, and specifically how Governor Cuomo's budget is affecting us as well. So Mr. Little will be arriving and starting the meeting at 6 p.m. There will be a question and answer period, and then we will go on to the budget workshop for what we have to finish up in looking for the rest of this $3.1 million that we still have. So I hope to see everyone on Thursday, March 29th, 6 p.m. at Temple Hill Academy. Thank you for being here this evening. Be it resolved that the work here